Hello and good morning, everybody. It is I, Grant Orion, and here we are back with another episode of Let's Play Pokemon Gold with our Gen 1 type challenge of Bug type. That just went in that time. So I was going to go take on the Elite Four a bunch off screen and level up my team, but as I went to do that, our rival showed up. So I was like, well, I'll just do this on stream just in case he shows up again, but I guess he's just random. So really what we're going to be doing this episode is just going, through the Elite Four. Oh, Beedrill just got dunked. Let me, revive him. So we're just gonna be leveling up on stream, so it's going to be fast like this. The way I kind of have this set up is Beedrill takes on the psychic trainer here. Shuffle takes on poison. Yanma takes on Bruno. Pinsir takes on Dark. And then whomever takes on Lance. It really doesn't matter. But we're just going to be speeding through this like this over and over until we, you know, get what we want. Just like so. So if you don't like that I'm going to be speeding up like this as I go through, then you might want to just hop out and wait till the next episode. But this is what we're going to be doing. We're going to level up our team against the Elite Four and prep for Red. And the only reason I'm speeding through this is because we've already fought and beat them once. That hurt. That did the trick. Hold on there for a second. We'll just keep Yanma up since he needs to level up still again. We'll switch here. Yama doesn't even have an attack that can hurt Gengar. Hmm. Blah 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 blah, Lance. We've already beaten you once. Look at that. And Lance is done already. Blah, 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 blah. And we've already done this once, so that's why we're skipping past this. And we're going to be just seeing this a lot. But this is the quickest way that we can... get everything set up. Buy a couple more revives, it seems, because our guys still go down. Alright, let's do it again. So we know that Twin Needle was not good enough to take out the Zatu, so we switched to Sludge Bomb, and that seemed to do the trick. Easy. Yeah, so Yanma still just dies to Machamp. And Yanma is the worst on our team. We knew that Yanma was the worst on our team. Just let it take out Mew. I'm not gonna Blah, 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 blah. So for those of you viewing, feel free to chat with me while we go on and take on the Elite Four. Thunder waves are a pain in the butt. So we have two left, one left. That hurt. Alright, let's just get through this again. So I'm conflicted as to what level we need to get our team to. I was thinking level 60 might be good enough to take on Red, but now I'm thinking we might need to get to like 65. I mean, this team just is junk. Well, some of this team. And there's always the chance, too, that as we walk in, our rival's gonna come fight us. Maybe that's just a Monday thing, I don't know. We're gonna let Pinsir take on Machamp because we know that Yanma can't do it. Good deal. Well, this is still going pretty fast. All things considered. Shuckle just gets to take on the Dragonites all the time. Getting there, we're at 58 now. We just come out of there fully healed, don't we? We'll just go in. We have plenty of items. If I need to get more after what, I will. Burned me. Ha, blah, 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 blah. Get out of here. I think we're gonna go for 65. We just wanna be safe. This really isn't taking us too long to get these levels. Thank you. just sad that these are the only people that we could fight, you know, consistently. I mean, even at 65, we're still going to be two levels under Red's team. We are getting to the point now where you can see the experience really playing in on the damage we're doing to these pokes. Alright, Shuckle. Killer of Dragonites. We missed. Missed again. Ooh. Fainted our Shuckle. Oh, that's fine. Exciting, isn't it? Just Elite Four over and over and over. I think we can make it, though, to 65 by the end of this episode. Remember, Pinsir is our powerhouse. I'm not really worried about him leveling up. It's really Yanma. I'm worried about Yanma leveling up. Which is why we keep Yama up front to go against these fights over and over, even though he's higher level. If we can get him to 65 first, then it's going to be easy pickings, and I did not mean to keep you out here. That's fine. That's not good. He's got a really bad turn with Shuffle there. Really? It really, it just seems like, you know, even the AI can still get lucky and just take us out, no problem. Five more levels. Or four more levels. Come on. That is the, what, fourth time we've been paralyzed? Flinched us with those rock slides. There's another run done. Well, run through the Elite Four, not this game. We still gotta take out Red. We're getting closer. Da-da-da-da-da. And so it begins. Those headbutts back, because we see the need in every single one. Alright, what do we need? 3, 1, 2, 3. missed that submission. Oops, I definitely missed a switch. Paralyzed again. Alright, we're getting close to 65. And then we'll see if we can go take on Red with a team with this team at 65. And if we can't take him at 65, then we'll just gain 5 more levels up to 70 and then try again. Alright, I think one more time after this one and we'll be high enough level. And there's the full paralysis. All right, one more time. not what I wanted. Do I need to buy? Just four full heals. That's not good. Paralyzed, really? All right. We are ready to go take on Red, everybody. So let's give this a save. So he's gonna start with his Pikachu. We're gonna see if we can just make this easy and keep Pinsir up front and see if we can sweep. Thank you. Not really sure where I'm going, so I hope I can find this. That was in the right way. Oh, I think this is it. See if we can take on red here. Now it may be level 81 Pikachu, but Pikachu's got some pretty bad stats. Alright, so he's gonna just drop our attack by what we raised it. We can just wait until we get it and see how much we take from this. Critical? Yeah. Well, critical hits aren't fair. See, if it's just a regular hit, we're fine. Alright, so that should be the last sword stance we need to be max hit. Good deal. Alright, he is faster. Come on, Pinsir. Survive this. That's a no-go. Alright, so this is the problem. Okay, fire spin's not gonna do too much. We have a max revive still. Doesn't look like I do. Okay, so we'll just try to take out Charizard here then. So that flamethrower's still gonna do some decent damage. And we got burned. And he's faster than us, so we're gonna need to use an item if we want to survive. Do we risk the rollout? I think we do. Maybe not. Maybe that was a bad idea. Hey, Overlord, Nader. Only four mons, yep. Yeah, there goes Shuckle. He's gonna go down to this. Alright, so... can Beedrill survive a flamethrower? Probably not. Probably should have just revived. Alright, so we revive the wall. We revive Pinsir. He's gonna send out Blastoise next, okay. Mew will eventually get its own run where we're using it, but for most parts, it will just be HM Slave. Okay, we take a buttload of damage from Surfs. That's not good. How much do we take with Pinsir from a Surf? Oh, he's started Rain Dance. That's not good. Can we get some flinches in? Oh, that's some high defense. Whirlpool, okay. We were at, like, what, 170? Man, look at this. What do we do here? That was a critical hit. Do we just lose? That's a loss, but let's see what we can do here. So we revive Shuckle. Alright, we're just gonna revive everybody here. Shuckle can take body slams all day from Snorlax. Christ. Now we've defense curled, okay. Just wanted to get past those rest turns. Snorlax is bulky as can be, we know that. Shuckle's just a wall, so yeah. If we need a stall, we put Shuckle on. I should have toxic Snorlax, but he'd probably just rest and get rid of it. That's the third hit of the rollout. So this fourth one should knock it out. And we still have one left, so let's see if we can take a hit from Espeon and take it out with a rollout. Okay, good job, Shuckle. We got it? Oh yeah. Oh yeah, we got it. Boom! And a flash of a light, he's gone. Good GG, Shuckle. That's right. Alright, so that means that we are done with this playthrough, and we get to see what our next team is going to be. Alright, let me get up on this tier. Grass team one done. Or sorry, bug team one done. Alright. So let me get to my desktop. Just close that really quick. Let's get to our D&D dice roller. Alright, so let's see what our starter is going to be first. So one is Chikorita. Two is Cyndaquil, three is Totodile. So we got a one. So we're going to be using a Chikorita. And now we need to see what type we're going to use. And there are 17 types. So type number two, which is poison type on our next playthrough. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 poison type Pokemon in Gen 2. So let's see what our team, it's going to be a team of 4. So let's see, our poison. Boom, number 14, which is Tentacool and Tentacruel. Let me write that down. Boom, number 11. So, 11. Oh, and I have these listed in alphabetical order as they as one of them appears in both Smoke God. So we have Nidoking line, so Nidoran male. Nidorino into Nidoking. Boom, number 13, which is Quillfish. And number 2, which is Spinarak and Ariados. So our team for our next playthrough is going to be Tentacool into Tentacruel. Nidoran up to Nidoking. Quillfish. And Spinarak to Ariados.